Welcome to Grab & Go Info. Databricks is a company founded by the creators of Apache Spark. The same name also refers to the data analytics platform that the company created. To create a Databricks account, go to https://databricks.com/try-databricks. You can choose between the free community version and the paid version. In this tutorial, I will talk about 1. How to create an access key and secret key for Databricks in AWS. 2. How to mount Databricks to a AWS S3 bucket. 3. How to read CSV files from the mounted AWS S3 bucket. 4. How to write data from Databricks to a AWS S3 bucket. Let's get started. In the first step, we will create a AWS access key and secret key for Databricks. Step 1.1. After uploading the data to an AWS S3 bucket, search IAM in the AWS search bar and click IAM from the search results. Step 1.2. Click Users under Access Management on the left-hand side of the page. Step 1.3. Click the blue Add Users button. Step 1.4. Enter username and choose access key, programmatic access as the AWS credential type. Step 1.5. Go to the Permissions section and select Attach Existing Policies directly. Then in the search bar type Amazon S3 Full Access and check the box in the search result. Step 1.6. We can skip the tag section and go to the review page. Step 1.7. Click the blue Create User button and you will see this page. Click the download.csv button to download the credential information. After downloading the CSV file with the AWS access key and secret access key, in step 2, we will upload this file to Databricks. Step 2.1. In the Databricks UI, click the compute icon. Step 2.2. Click the blue Create Cluster icon and give the new cluster a name under cluster name. Choose a Databricks runtime version and click Create Cluster. I am using the free Databricks Community Edition. The paid version has more options. Step 2.3. It takes a few minutes to spin up the cluster. The cluster is ready when there is a green circle in front of the cluster name. Step 2.4. Click the data icon and then click the Create Table button. Keep in mind that you need to have a cluster running before creating a table. Step 2.5. Click Drop Files to upload, or click to browse and upload the CSV file downloaded from AWS in step 1. After the file is successfully uploaded, you will see a green checkmark next to the file name. In step 3, we will mount S3 bucket to Databricks. Step 3.1, create a new notebook by clicking Create, your workspace, and the downward arrow next to your email. Now let's open the notebook. Step 3.2 checks the contents in file store by running dbutils.fs.ls. We can see that the tutorial demo.csv is in the file store tables folder. Step 3.3 is to mount the S3 bucket. We first need to import libraries. pispark.sql.functions has the functions for pispark. Erlib is the package for handling URL. Next, let's read the CSV file with AWS keys to Databricks. We specify the file type to be CSV. Indicate that the file has first row as the header and comma as the delimiter. Then the path of the CSV file was passed in to load the file. After that, we get the access key and secret key from the Spark data frame. The secret key was encoded for security purposes. Safe equals blank means every character in the secret key is encoded. After getting the access key and secret key, it's time to mount the S3 bucket. We can mount the bucket by passing in the S3 path and the desired mount name. It returns true if the bucket is mounted successfully. In step 4.1, we check the contents in the mounted S3 bucket. Step 4.2 reads a dataset in CSV format from S3 to Databricks. We set the delimiter to be a comma, indicate that the first row is the header, and ask Spark to infer the schema. In step 4.3, we save data as a table in Parquet format on Databricks for future access. If the table was saved before and we want to override it, the Allow Creating Manage Table Using Non-Empty Location needs to be set to true. Step 5 saves Spark data frame to S3 bucket. We can use df.write.save to save the Spark data frame directly to the mounted S3 bucket. CSV format is used as an example here, but it can be other formats. If the file was saved before, we can remove it before saving the new version. To unmount the S3 bucket, use dbutils.fs.unmount. In this tutorial, we covered 1. How to create an access key and secret key for Databricks in AWS. 2. How to mount Databricks to S3 bucket. 3. How to read CSV files from the mounted S3 bucket. 4. How to write data from Databricks to S3 bucket. If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. I publish tutorials on machine learning, deep learning, and big data processing every week. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the code and explanations in the video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.